error of not even daring to call upon a single soul among the hundred who surround him. I think that is the initial experience of the West Indian arriving. However tough he is, for the first time in his whole experience, he is alone.
Eventually, however, you get settled.
You get settled, and then you too become part of the strangeness.
All right then, Mother. I'll tell you the truth. We went to Pylos and reached Nestor, shepherd of his people. He welcomed us in his lofty home with hospitality and kindness, as a father for a son who's just returned from far-off places after many years. Of brave Odysseus, alive or dead, he told me he'd heard nothing from any man on earth. He sent me off with horses and a well-built chariot to that famous spearman, Menelaus, son of Atreus. There I saw Argive Helen. Menelaus, skilled at war shouts, at once asked me why I'd come to lovely Sparta, what I was looking for. I told him the truth, all the details. I told him they ripped away my clothes, cloak and tunic, and dressed me differently, a ragged cloak and filthy tunic ripped to bits. Inside that well-decked ship, they tied me up with tightly twisted rope and went ashore. The gods themselves with ease untied my bonds, and so I slipped away down a smooth plank into the sea. They brought me here,